everyone. So far we have discussed about the three hinged arches. That is, in the previous cases we have discussed the supports are at the same level. Okay, so we'll be discussing like this. So the arches will be like this. Here you will be having one hinge, here one hinge, and at the crown you will be having one hinge. This is called three hinged arches. So this both the supports are at the same level. This is one kind of three-hinged arches we have discussed in the earlier classes. Okay, now what we are going to discuss is we are going to discuss the same three-hinged arches which are having different levels. Okay, so you can see here there will be one hinge, here there will be one hinge, and at the crown you will be having one hinge. Okay, so it is very clear for you. So here you can see, okay, it will be like this. Okay, so both the supports A, B are at different levels. They are not at the same level. In real life structures, we can see this. If you are going to connect two hilly regions using some arch, means they cannot be in the same level. The level may differ. Okay, by that way, in that situation, we will be going for these kind of arches where we need to analyze these kind of arches. Okay, so now let me explain this arches. So we are clear. We are going to discuss about the three hinged arches. You know what is three hinged arches, right? This is hinge at A. Here you will be having one more hinge at B, and at the crown you will be having one more hinge named as C. You can see here. Just draw the imaginary line for the reference. Okay, so this distance, okay, this distance is named as L1, and let me name this distance as L2, and the overall span of this arch is named as L. Okay, so you are having two different levels. At support A, this height, this rise is called R1. Okay, from crown to the support B, this rise is named as R2. You know what is meant by rise. Okay, so they have given an equation called L1 divided by L2 equal to square root of R1 divided by R2. Okay, so we don't need to know the derivation for our syllabus. You just write down these formulas. Okay, so L1 means that this is the span of the support in the left side to the hinge, to the center point. Okay, so that distance is called L1. L2 is the distance between the midspan of the arch to the support B, that is called L2. You know what is mean by R1. R1 is the rise of the support A. Okay, R2 is the rise of the support B. Okay, so for these four, so you know what are these four terms denotes, and we have one equation corresponding to these four terminologies. Okay, so by making use of this equation, you can find the value of L1, L2. If suppose they are giving, they are asking to find the value of L1 and L2, means what shall we do? Means you should know the value of R1 and R2 first. You know that L1 plus L2 will be equal to L. Okay, I'm right. See, L1. This is L1. You know this is L1 plus L2. Plus L2 will be equal to L. I think it is clear. Okay. So this is one equation. So by using this itself, you can find the value of R1 and R2 and all. Okay. So you can write like this. You can write L1 equal to x times of L2. Right, because you just see, you know the value. Suppose they are giving the value of R1 and R2, say if they are giving the R1 as 2 and R2 as 4, you will be getting like this. Okay, L1 by L2. So what comes here? Root of 1 by 2 into L1 by L2. So you can write it like this. L1 is equal to root of 1 by 2 into L2, and then you can substitute this L1 value in this equation. Okay, in this equation L1, you can, here for L1 you can substitute this value, and you can obtain the value of L1 and L2. This is one case. Or they will be giving the value of L1 and L2, and they will be asking you to find the value of R1 and R2. Okay, so let us move on to our question. Let us discuss one problem based on this concept. Okay, So this is our arch, okay? So I am having a 3-hinged arch. You can make it as a question. You are provided with a 3-hinged arch. The third hinge is placed at the crown, that is named as a C. Okay? They have given L1 as 6 meter and L2 as, they didn't give the value of L2, but they have given the overall span as 15 meter. Okay? Then they have given the value of R1 equal to 2 meter. You don't know the value of R2. And also they have given that this arch is loaded with an UDL of 20 kN per meter running over the portion AC. This is the portion AC. Okay. In the portion AC, there is one UDL. Okay. So its span will also be equal to 6 meter. This is very obvious because this is 6 meter. So this will be also equal to 6 meter. This is the loading condition. What they have asked us to find is, you just write it down here. First, they are asking us to find the horizontal thrust, H. You know what is meant by horizontal thrust. Okay. Next, they asked us to find the maximum bending moment. It will be negative here. So you can write it as negative. Maximum bending moment. And the third one is, they are asking us to find the value. They are asking us to find the value of normal thrust and radial shear. Okay, normal thrust and radial shear. You may ask me what is that D. Okay, D refers to the section. Okay, so in this beam they are providing one section that is called, that section D is at a distance of 3 meter from A. This is given in the question. So at this point, at the point D, so you can see here there will be the section at the distance of 3 meter. Okay, you can just write it down. So that is called it section D. So at that point, what will be the value of the radial shear and the normal thrust? That is your question. So let us move on to the problem now. Okay. First, shall I write it, draw it clearly, then it will be easy. So board is not sufficient. We shall draw it smallly. This distance is L1, overall span is L, this is R1, and this is R2. You don't know the value of R2, you know only the value of R1 as 2 meter and L1 as 6 meter. You don't know the value of this and you know this is as 15 meter. Okay, so let us move on to the problem now. So you know L1 plus L2 equal to L. You know the value of L1. 6 plus L2 equal to 15. So L2 will be equal to 9 meter. Up to this, I think you are clear. Okay, next what we are going to do is, we are going to find the value of R1 and R2. So next, you know the equation, L1 divided by L2 is equal to square root of R1 divided by R2. L1 value is equal to 6 divided by 9 equal to square root of R1 is 2 divided by R2. So you can square on both sides to get the value of R2. We are squaring on both the sides. Now what will be the answer? 36 divided by 81. So 6 square equal to 36 and 9 square is 81 equal to. So this root will get cancelled when you are making square. So this will become 2 divided by R2. So the value of R2 is, you can just cancel it here, it becomes 18. So according to 9 table, this is 2 and this is 9. So the value is 4.5 meter. So you found the value of L2 and R2. So we shall write it here. Okay, using different color, we can write what we have found. I'm going to confuse now. We shall write. write it using different color, then it will be easy for us to understand. So you found this value as 4.5 meter, and you found the value of L2 as 9 meter. Okay, so up to this we are clear. Next, what we are going to do? Next, they are asking us to find the horizontal thrust acting on the arches. So you know what is the horizontal thrust? The purpose of horizontal thrust is, the purpose means it is the force quantity that is capable to resist the moment caused due to the load acting on the arches. You know that. Okay, we have already discussed what is the horizontal thrust. It will be acting in the horizontal direction at the support. Okay, let me draw here. So here you will be having horizontal thrust. Here also you will be having horizontal thrust. Here you will be having vertical reaction VA, and here it will be VP. Okay, so after this you will be clear. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to, and also you should note one more point here. See, from this point to this point, it is 4.5 meter. You are clear, right? And also you are clear that from this point, it is 2 meter. So this distance will be equal to 2.5 meter. Okay, so the difference in level between the two supports, you can write it like this. Okay, difference in level between two supports equal to R2 minus R1, which is equal to 4.5 minus 2 equal to 2.5 meter. You can write it like this for your understanding purpose. Next, what we are going to do is, we are going to find the value of horizontal thrust. Okay, see, usually what we will be doing in 3 hinged arches means we will be taking moment about the point P. Because if you are taking moment about the point P, means you can find the value of VA, H and all easily as possible. But now these are at a different levels. If it is in the same level, means you can take it easily. Okay, VA pothu you will be taking the moment. Okay, but if you see here, what is the problem here means, since they are in different level, the horizontal thrust will also cause momentum. Here, if the horizontal thrust is acting, means its line of action is along the moment chosen area. Okay, line of action is parallel to, at the same point where you are considering the moment. So, the moment caused due to the horizontal thrust will be equal to zero. But this is at a different level. Okay, so it will have some distance. Okay, so its perpendicular distance is somewhat, there is some value. So it will be h into x. You will be getting the value of moment due to horizontal thrust also. So you cannot take moment about the point B. And instead of that, what I am going to do is, I am going to take moment about the point C with respect to right side of the arch and also to the left portion of the arch. You can see here, this is the right portion. Okay, this is the right portion. And this is the left portion. I am splitting it into two for my understanding purpose. Okay. Okay. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to take moment about hinge C. You can write it as hinge C or support C. Okay. And we are choosing the right portion. Sorry, left portion. First, let me choose left portion. Okay, so now what happens here, you are having the vertical reaction VA into its corresponding distance is 6 meter minus you are having load here. Okay, you know here the load is acting 20 kilonewton per meter. You know the load intensity is 20 into its distance, and its perpendicular distance is 6/2, or you may write it as 3. Okay, minus you are having one more thing called horizontal reaction, and it is having some distance, that is h into its rise value is distance equal to 0. By solving this, you will be getting the equation as 6VA minus 2H minus 360 equal to 0. Okay, next what I am going to do is, I am going to consider right portion. okay, right portion of C. When I am considering right portion, what I am having here, I am having VB and H. I am not having any load in this direction. Here you can see you are having three force quantity in the left portion. One is horizontal thrust, one is vertical reaction at the point A, and the load. Here the load is missing, so we are having only two quantities. One is VB, that is vertical reaction at the point B into its corresponding distance is 9 meter, minus horizontal thrust into its rise is now 4.5. Am I right? Which is equal to 0. So you are having two equations, right? 9 VB minus 0.5 H equal to 0. So just name this as equation 1, this as equation 2, and you are having, in addition to this, you are having one more equation, that is VA plus VB, that is total summation of the vertical force equal to 0. Okay, VA, vertical force, upward direction you are having VA and VB, and in downward direction you are having the 20 kN UDL. So you have to multiply it with its distance, that is 6. So VA plus VB equal to 120. This is equation number 3. By using these three equations, 1, 2 and 3, you will be getting the value of VA as 80. You should solve and write it, okay? VB will be equal to 36 kN, and then H will be equal to 72 kN. So we found the value of horizontal thrust. So your first one is done. Okay, so we are clear. Next, what we have to do? Next, we have to move on to the second question. Second question is, they asked us to find the maximum moment. Am I right? They are asking the maximum moment. This causes the negative bending moment. So, let us find the maximum bending moment. See, usually your, this is your arch, right? How your bending moment diagram will vary for this kind of arch means, here you are having UDL in this portion. Up to this point you are having UDL, right? So it will be like this, and then it will be like, so this variation will be linear because there is no load. Since there is no load, there is no nothing, there is no, there is only linear variation. Okay, this is your bending moment diagram, you know very well. But this variation will depend upon the equation what you are providing. Okay, so this is the just the bending moment diagram shape for the arcs were considered. Okay, next we shall move on to find the value of so now here you are having one problem. See, let me draw it bigger. This is your arch, right? C, A, and this is V. Here you are having VA, you know the value of VA, you are having H here, and you will be having VB, you will be having horizontal thrust here, you know the distance and all, that is not a problem. Now, what is the thing is, see, to find the maximum bending moment, what we have to do is, we have to make this, okay, write it down, we have to make the arch look symmetrical. We have to make the arch to look symmetrical. For that purpose, what I am going to do is, I am going to extend the arch. So, it render symmetrical means, what does it mean? With respect to the this point, with respect to the midpoint, if I see, both should have the mirror image. Here the support level is different, here the support level is different. To make this symmetrical section, what I am doing is, I am just extending this level and I am naming this as A dash. Okay, now what I am going to do is, I am going to take one section, write it down, taking a section xx at a distance of small x from the support B. Okay, so you know the value of VA, VB and H and all. And also you know the moment equation for the arches. What is it? You will be having the moment value with respect to the smoothly supported beam minus the reduction factor. Reduction factor is horizontal thrust into its corresponding distance. So here the rise, y value is this. Okay, you know what is mean by rise. This is your rise here. Okay. So now what I am doing is, now I have to find the value of this mx. Okay, so I know the value of bp is 36. Am I right? The value of bp is 36 kilonewton. So I am going to substitute that here, 36 into x, and also I know the value of h as 72 into y. So you should know the value of y. You know y is equal to, rise is equal to, this is equal to the parabolic equation, 4r divided by l square into x into l minus x. We have discussed this in the earlier class itself. You know the value of r equal to 4.5 meter. Can you tell me why? Because here we are considering the point B. With respect to the point B only we have extended this. So the center point rise r will be equal to 4.5 meter. Okay, so it will be equal to 4.5, and the value of L is equal to, see, this is not changed. Okay, so this is already, it is 9 meter. Okay, so you are extending to the same distance means that this horizontal length will also change to the same distance. If it is here means you will be having the value as 6 meter. Since we are extending this point, the length, the span in the left portion will also be equal to the right portion, that is equal to 9 meter. So the value of L is L1 plus L2, which is equal to 9 plus 9 equal to 18 meters. So you have the value of R and L here. Next unknown is X. So to find the X, we have to first substitute these values in the equation. Okay, now Y equal to 4 into 4.5 divided by 18 square into X into 18 minus X. On solving, I will be getting this value as 4x into 18 minus x. Next, what I will be doing, I will be using this value, this y value in this equation. So what happens to mx now? The value of mx will be equal to 36x minus 4x into 18 minus x. On solving this, you will be getting the value of mx as 36x minus 72x plus 4x square. Okay, we can write this equation as equation. So far we have written three equations, right? So we can name this as equation number 4. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to differentiate this moment with respect to x, and I am going to equate this to 0, because I want, this is the bending moment equation. Okay, so you are clear, this is the bending moment equation. So I have, if I substitute the value of x, I will be getting the moment at each and every point in the arch. That is clear in this equation. Okay, so what they have asked in question is, they are asking us to find the maximum bending moment. To find the maximum, what we will be doing, we will be differentiating that term and then we will be equating it to the 0. To get maximum, you know the maxima and minima in max, right? Okay, to get maximum bending moment or to get any maximum value, okay, you will be differentiating that value, okay, differentiating that value or term with respect to variables and then equate that into 0. Okay, that is what I did here. I am going to differentiate this equation 4 with respect to x and I am going to equate it to 0. Okay, write these points in your note, otherwise you will be getting confused. You don't know why we have differentiated here. Okay, so just write down, point, get the maximum value, you are going to differentiate that. Okay, so what happens, 36 minus 72 plus 8x is equal to 0. Okay, I am differentiating this equation 4, then I will be getting the value like this. So on solving, the value of x will be equal to 4.5 meter. So now I found the value of x, but I didn't find the value of maximum bending moment. What I have to do? I have to substitute this value of x in the equation 4 to get the maximum bending moment. Okay, so substitute 36 into 4.5. Okay, minus 72 into 4.5 plus 4 into 4.5 the whole square. So the maximum bending moment will be equal to minus 81 kilonewton meter. So we found the two things. One, we found the horizontal thrust, and second, we found the maximum bending moment. And next, what we are going to find? We are going to find the value of normal thrust and radial shear. Okay. So far we found these two values. In the same arch, what we are going to do is, we are going to take one section to find the radial shear, because they have given like that, right? To find the radial shear and the normal thrust, what we have to do? We have to plot one section that has been mentioned in the question. So you can just erase these things in your arch. You draw the new arch. See, this is your existing arch. Okay. This is your existing arch. What they asked you to do? Mark one section D. So this is my section D, which is at the distance of 3 meters. Okay, what they asked me is to find the radial shear and horizontal thrust. So I have to consider this point. Like how means, see, I'm just taking one cut here, like that you imagine. So here is the point D. Here I will be having horizontal thrust, and in this point I will be having one shear. Okay, I can just name it as VA or whatever. Okay. In addition to this, so before coming to this, let us also find the resultant of the resultant reaction at the point A. Okay, you will be having resultant reaction here. Okay, before writing this diagram, you just do this. You will be having resultant reaction here. You can write it as RA, because you are having two reactions, sir. Horizontal and vertical. So there will be one resultant perpendicular to this. It will be acting at any angle. That angle is called theta. So we are going to find these values. So for that, you are having a formula. You know, this is also according to the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, so you will be getting like this. Right, here is your theta A, R A. This is your H and this is your B. So you need to find this value, right? So for that, what I am going to write is tan theta is equal to VA divided by H. Okay, VA divided by H. So theta is equal to what? Tan inverse of VA divided by H. So you will be getting the, when you are substituting the value of VA and H, you will be getting the value of theta as 49.24°. Okay, so resultant RA is equal to square root of VA square plus H square. So by substituting these values, we will be getting the resultant as 110.635 kN. Okay. Next, we are going to find the value of radial shear and horizontal thrust at the section D. So I have told what is the section D. It will be here. We shall name this section as D, which is acting at the distance of 3 meters from the lift support. This is given in the question itself. What we are going to find is, at this point, you are going to find the value of radial shear and horizontal thrust. To find the value of radial shear and horizontal thrust, you should also know the value of vertical shear and the horizontal thrust acting at this point. Okay, so now I am just taking this portion alone, and I will be drawing separately. Then it will be easy for you to understand. Let me draw here. Quotient D. Okay. So what is here? Here you will be having Vx. Here you will be having pitch. So in this portion, normal thrust, okay, will be acting, name it as Px. Okay. Along this direction, you will be having your radial shear. You can name this as Fx. Okay. And also you know the equation. What are the two equations? For normal thrust, it can be written as h cos theta plus vx sin theta. And for radial shear, that is fx, it is vx cos theta minus h sin theta. Okay, so first you should know the value of h, vx and theta. Then only you can find the two values, that is the radial shear and this normal thrust. Okay, for that first I am going to find the value of this Vx. See, this is Vx, right? So Vx is equal to, consider this portion alone. Here you are having one UDL also, right? Okay, consider this portion, this left portion. Here you are having what? This Va. Okay, what is the value? You can write it here. Vx. So since we are considering the shear force, you can consider only the vertical load, no need to consider the horizontal thrust. Okay, this is acting in the upward direction, so the sign convention is plus. Next, you are having this UDL. This UDL is acting in the downward direction. The UDL intensity is 20 and its distance is, overall distance is 6 meter, but I am taking the section only at the distance of 3 meter. So up to this only I should consider. So here also I should consider only up to that 3 meter. You know the value of Va as 84 meter. On substituting 84 minus this 60, you will be getting the value of Vx as 24 kilonewton. Okay, next what I am going to do is, I am going to find the value of horizontal thrust and, sorry, you know the value of horizontal thrust already. Now we are going to find the value of theta. Okay, so you can draw the diagram and then also you can find, or you know this formula already, right? Theta is equal to tan inverse of 4r divided by l square into l minus 2x. Okay, this is a formula to find the value of theta. Okay, here also you should make the arch symmetrical, then only you can find the value of theta. So now I am going to make the arch symmetrical. For that, what I am going to do is, let me draw it in different color. See, this is your symmetrical arch. This is the point B dash. I am stopping here itself. So if it is L1, if this distance is L1, this distance will also be equal to L1. Okay, so your symmetrical arch now considered will be like this. Let me draw here. It will be in the same level. Okay, you are having A. Here it is B dash. Okay. This is 6 meter. This is 6 meter. And here you are having your hinge. Okay. So, now the value of L here will be equal to 6 plus 6, which is equal to 12 meter. The value of R will be equal to 2 meter. Okay. So, because see here, you know here it is 2 meter, right? So, you can take the value of R as 2 meter. Now, substitute these values in the equation, you will be getting the value of theta as 4 into 2 divided by 12 square into 12 minus 2 into 3. Okay. X value is 3. Because see here, this is the distance of 3 meter. So, the value of theta will be 18.43 degree. Okay. You can write as sine theta will be equal to 0.31692. And cos theta will be equal to 0.9487. Okay, so you can now substitute. Now you successfully found the value of V dx sin theta cos theta. You already know the value of horizontal thrust. Now you can use the equation. You can substitute in this equations and then you can find the answer now. So Px is equal to 72 into 0.9487 plus the value of Px is 24 into sine theta is 0.3162. So the value of Px is equal to 75.895 kilonewton. Okay, this is your normal thrust. Next, radial shear. Fx is equal to 24 into 0.9487, that is cos theta, minus 72 into 0.3162. So your radial shear value will be equal to 0.0024. This is approximately equal to 0. So the Fx value is equal to 0 and the value of Px is equal to 75.895. So this is about the three hinged arches which are having different level conditions. Okay, so we found the value of horizontal thrust. Initially we found the value of horizontal thrust. Okay, then we also found the value of maximum bending moment, and then we found the value of radial shear and normal thrust and radial shear. Okay, thank you all. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.